We Can Be Heroes isn't like any other superpower team-up you've seen. While most costumed adventures focus on the world's mightiest heroes, Robert Rodriguez's new adventure comedy puts the focus on their kids. Good thing, too, because a whole fleet of alien invaders arrive on Earth and capture the heroics, the world's premier super team. No matter how old you are, We Can Be Heroes offers a fresh spin on tried-and-true superhero tropes. And it's a lot of fun for viewers of all ages. It's also full of Easter eggs and other references for all kinds of viewers. Like the movie itself, there's something for everyone hidden among the movie's smallest details. For anyone who grew up on Robert Rodriguez's family films, We Can Be Heroes is an extra special treat. While the tone is very different, the movie features appearances from the heroes of Rodriguez's surreal 2005 fantasy escapade, The Adventures of Sharkboy and Lavagirl. We Can Be Heroes is full of subtle nods and references to the hero's original movie, even before they enter the story. A graphic novel called Lavagirl Adventures rests on Missy's bedside table alongside some action figures. The cereal Missy eats for breakfast is called Great White Bites, and has a mascot that looks a lot like the CG creatures from the 2005 movie. Robert Rodriguez didn't make We Can Be Heroes alone. He had some help, and much of it came from his ultra-talented family. Most notably, We Can Be Heroes was co-produced by Rodriguez's son, Racer Max, who is a fundamental part of the Sharkboy and Lavagirl legacy. When Racer was just a kid, he created Sharkboy and illustrated his earliest adventures. You can also catch him in a quick cameo in We Can Be Heroes as a helicopter pilot. But Robert and Racer aren't the only Rodriguezes who show up in We Can Be Heroes credits. In fact, every single one of Robert's five children contributed to the film. We Can Be Heroes is all about family after all.
You see that, eh? Did you see what my son just did?
Unfortunately, I was too busy looking at my own cool kid.
Acapella, played by actress Lotus Blossom, has one of the coolest power sets in We Can Be Heroes. Like her mother, the heroic known as Mrs. Vox, Acapella can control matter by singing. If she hits the right note, Acapella can even create vibrations that make her, her friends, and inanimate objects fly.
Show her how you make things float.
But powers aren't the only thing that Acapella and Mrs. Vox have in common. They also share a voice. While Blossom is extraordinarily charming as the young superhero, she only delivers Acapella speaking lines. When she sings, her voice is provided by musician Haley Reinhardt, who also appears in We Can Be Heroes as Mrs. Vox herself.
We can be heroes just for one day.
Sorry, it was there for the taking.
1975's Jaws didn't just catapult Steven Spielberg's career into the stratosphere, it also pretty much invented the now ubiquitous summer blockbuster, forever changing how movies are both made and consumed. Jaws also happens to be one of Rodriguez's favorite movies. As he told Rotten Tomatoes, the film premiered on his 7th birthday, and he couldn't have gotten a better present. Over 30 years later, he's also had a great time sharing the movie with his kids, cementing the film as a Rodriguez family favorite. Given all that, it's not too surprising to see a subtle Jaws Easter egg pop up in We Can Be Heroes. Early in the film, when Guppy is showing off her powers, she creates the image of a clueless swimmer being hunted by a shark that just happens to look exactly like Roger Castle's original Jaws poster. If you're a film fan, there's no mistaking it. We Can Be Heroes borrows its title from the lyrics of a classic tune, but if you're in the movie's target age demographic, there's a decent chance you haven't heard it before. After all, David Bowie's Heroes, the title track on his 12th studio album, was released all the way back in 1977. Even if you're not familiar with Bowie's original recording, you've already heard the tune. A cover of Heroes plays over We Can Be Heroes' superpowered training montage, while Acapella belts out another just before the movie's climax.
Can you hear them?
Yes, it sounds like... they're rocking out.
Instead of donning fancy outfits like their parents, the kids in We Can Be Heroes decide to go stealth. However, funnily enough, many of them are already wearing low-key costumes, although they may not realize it. Many of the heroic's children sport clothing with superhero-like emblems right on their chests, giving a small hint as to their powers. Fast Forward has a TV remote icon associated with her codename on her shirt. Wheels Polo is adorned with a lightning bolt pattern, indicating both his superior strength and his high-tech wheelchair. Noodles T has a picture of a steaming bowl of ramen, while Slowmo says fully charged, playing off the idea that his speed powers are functioning at full capacity, which has him trapped in some kind of time warp. Of course, at the very end of the movie, the young heroes get their own set of uniforms, and they're notable for what they don't have. No capes, bright colors, or masks. Instead, the new costumes are sleek, functional, and extremely practical, proof that, in the end, these kids really did learn something from their parents. Thanks for watching! Click the links in our video to watch more from Netflix Film Club. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.